ladies and gentlemen, Daniel Betts.
"2023 was the hottest year ever recorded. But unless you were paying attention to climate news, I bet you didn't notice. Instead, most of us spent the summers wearing sweaters inside air-conditioned spaces. We just didn't notice. But air conditioning is really important. Most people don't know that extreme heat kills more people than any other weather-related event. More than hurricanes, tornadoes, flooding, and cold weather. I am Daniel Betts, and I have a PhD in mechanical engineering with particular concentration in the science of heat. But I'm an entrepreneur and a dad who wants to see future generations be able to live in a planet that's healthy, resilient, and sustainable. For this reason, I am on a mission to revolutionize air conditioning. Why? Well, air conditioning has a dark side. Like a drug that alleviates the symptoms of the disease that it causes, air conditioners are major emitters of greenhouse gases, which cause global climate change. Present air conditioning technology was invented over 100 years ago, actually right here in Florida. That technology works by pumping heat from inside your building to the outside. And this consumes a lot of electricity. But it also swims upstream. The hotter it is outside, the more difficult it is for your air conditioner to pump the heat from inside the building to that hot outside. This translates to increased electricity consumption and decreasing cooling capacity when you need it the most. We all notice that in our electric bill in the summer. But utilities don't have it easy. We've all heard about blackouts due to extreme heat. And these are caused because when it's hot outside and our air conditioners would run at the lowest efficiency, we all turn our air conditioners on at the same time. And this puts enormous strain on the electrical infrastructure. In fact, the entire electrical infrastructure of the grid is designed to try to meet the peak demand for air conditioning. And we're all trying to decarbonize, right, the grid by deploying renewable energy. Well, solar power produces electricity from the early morning into the early afternoon. However, the moment that we experience the hottest period of the day turns out to be into the late afternoon, and that's when we use the majority of the air conditioning. In fact, we continue to use air conditioning into the night. And guess how utilities bridge the gap between electricity consumption from air conditioning and renewable power generation? By turning on fossil fuel-consuming power plants. Conventional air conditioners mostly consume dirty electricity. And this problem is only getting worse. The International Energy Agency has estimated that by 2050, global electricity consumption for air conditioning will be equivalent to today's total electricity consumption for China and India combined. This level of explosive growth could undermine our capacity to put in place enough renewable energy systems to meet decarbonization goals and ward off a climate disaster. All right. How are you guys feeling? Is the air conditioner still keeping you comfortable in here? Well, this uneasy feeling is what drove me to try to find a solution to the air conditioning problem. And this solution can be understood by knowing two things that we here in South Florida understand very well, and that is sweat and salt. Okay, let's talk about sweat. Your body keeps cool by evaporating water from your skin, sweat. And the capacity of that water to evaporate is highly determined by the humidity of the air, which determines the speed at which you can evaporate that water. That is why when it's 90 degrees Fahrenheit outside here in Florida, in Miami, and it's humid, we are dying. But in places like Las Vegas, at 90 degrees Fahrenheit and when it's dry, people are happily strolling about talking about the dry heat. In Florida, we're sweaty and sticky. In Las Vegas, sweat is evaporating from your skin, keeping you cool and comfortable. It's all about the dry heat. However, this is a very good method of cooling things off. In fact, did you know that to evaporate water, it takes 900 times the energy than to raise its temperature by 1 degree Fahrenheit? So, evaporation cools way more than changes in temperature. So let's recap. Evaporation is a very good way of creating cooling. And your comfort is highly dependent on humidity. Okay, now let's talk about salt. Have you noticed in the summer that your salt shaker, in the salt in it, comes together? And that's because salts are very good at absorbing humidity from the air. There are certain types of salts that do this so well that they are always in liquid form, diluted by the water that they're absorbing from the atmosphere all the time. So we can take the concept of liquid desiccants and of water evaporation to create an ultra-efficient new type of air conditioner. So first, we take a heat exchanger. And if you look at the face of the heat exchanger, we pass liquid desiccant and we pass air over this liquid desiccant. And like the salt in your salt shaker, the liquid desiccant readily absorbs the water from the air, creating desert-like Las Vegas-type air inside the heat exchanger. Then we use evaporation to cool down this air. And by what we do is we take a small portion of the air, now the dry air, we pass it on the back side of the plate, and it evaporates this water that's flowing on the back end of the plate, cooling down the entire system. The result is low humidity, low temperature air, voila, air conditioning. But notice something. Water evaporation did not take electricity. The only electricity-consuming portion of this system is the process of reconcentrating the liquid desiccant so that it can be used again and again and again. This results in ultra-efficiency, meaning that this system consumes from 50 to 90% less energy than a conventional air conditioner. But wait, there's more. The process of reconcentrating the liquid desiccant can occur at any time because I can store the liquid desiccant, giving me energy storage and air conditioning all at the same time. Imagine this. You can run your air conditioner without any energy consumption or electricity consumption when renewable energy is not available, and only consume the electricity when renewable energy is plentiful. And electricity produced from renewable energy is the lowest cost electricity. In other words, running this type of air conditioning saves you money and decreases infrastructure cost for the grid, saving everyone money. What I love about this idea is that we're using technology to create resiliency, decarbonization, health, and human comfort. With this, we can make air conditioning an ally in our fight against global climate change. Thank you.